so yeah. Check this out. So this room right here.
Yeah. Wow.
Which
it's a big room.
It's a
big room, Robert.
Yeah, check this out.
It's a game room.
This is what I'm gonna turn it to a game room. Little by little, I'm gonna change the floor.
Put a wall here or something, or no?
I'm gonna put like a hockey table.
Yeah.
Then, you know, more TVs around.
Huh.
I'm gonna put a pool table and a foosball table.
Like, yeah.
It's gonna be like a little sports bar.
Man cave, as they say.
All my movies are there.
All right, give me your top five favorite movies of Robert Garcia.
My favorite?
Top five.
Well, okay, I'll tell you my favorite right now is, where's the S right here?
Are they categorized?
This is my favorite right here.
Why?
Favorite all time
movie. Shawshank Redemption, great movie. With Andy and the bird and Brooke.
This is a fucking badass movie. That's my favorite movie.
That's a great movie.
And after that, I have, right here, let me see. Right here, this is my second best movie.
What is it?
Men of Honor.
Oh, you can handle the truth.
Oh man, this is a badass movie.
You should have every fighter watch that one, Robert.
Yes.
No,
yes,
I'm serious.
Yes. Like, yeah, no, for real.
Phil Jackson, the basketball coach, has basketball players read books. You need to have them watch movies.
That's my favorite movie.
Okay.
Those are my two, and then I like movies like you know, I like all my Mexican movies too here.
Yeah.
All my Mexican movies, El Ausente, you know, all those movies from Valentino, you know, Mexican movies, Valentino Rio, about Mario Armada. Vicente Fernandez, you know what I mean?
So, look, yesterday, we can't tell them the name of the game show, but yesterday you taped the game show, a very popular one,
right,
with a lot of stars.
It was fun, I love it.
Tell me about it, the interaction with the James Tonys,
James Tonys fucking hilarious.
He is. He confiscated my camera twice yesterday.
My God, he's hilarious, man.
He's a big fan. He's a nice guy.
I love him. I met with him, you know, he's doing his thing, you know, I love him. He's badass.
He's only one of two guys in history to win championships from 160 to
Chris
heavyweight.
Chris Bird.
Yeah. Very smart
Olympic
guy.
Silver medal from the 90s Olympics. People don't know that. Chris Bird was there. I haven't seen him and his wife in so many years. It was so much fun seeing them. You know, so then, you know, that's my...
That's your little corner.
Yeah.
So by the way, you know Shannon Briggs is a my fight David Haye.
Yeah, I heard.
What do you think?
So right here, Ellie, this is where I have... this is more like my office. Well, let me turn on the light.
This is like Chapo's office. Tonight,
you gangster. I'm not a fucking Chapo, but I'm fucking Scarface type of gang. You know what I mean?
It's a very nice
I'm
office,
like
Robert.
Scarface type of fucking office. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is my fucking office right here. Still in remodeling, but
really cool.
I got my IBF belt right here. I got my NABF belt. This is an award City of Oxnard gave me right here.
Wow. What does it say on the plaque?
Robert Garcia, Oxnard's first world champion, March 13, 1998, which was a week ago. I win versus Harold Warren, IBF junior lightweight champion. Trainer of the Year award.
Oh, congratulations.
2012, Trainer of the Year.
You should have had like three or four of those by now.
No, but it's all politics. These are boxing gloves, my good friend from New York, Osman.
Yeah.
He does that for me. He did this. And he did this one right here. Check this out. This one right here. When I was a champion, IBF champion.
Wow.
Solid rock. You know, this crystal IBF champion right here. He did that for me.
It says Garcia?
He's good. Yeah. It's IBF champion right
here. That's really cool, Robert.
You know, and I got my fighters, you know, my Donna, Brandon. You know, those are my, you know, top.
You know what Brandon told me on the phone? I interviewed him yesterday.
Huh?
That you used to wrestle with him? Because I asked him if he would do MMA. And he said that you grabbed him in the balls until he's...
I would. Hey, I ain't going to lose a fucking match with nobody. Whatever it is, I'm never gonna lose.
No,
if it's a street fight, if it's a fucking game, whatever, I'm never gonna
lose. You're gonna win.
If I have to fucking choke,
whatever it takes.
I'll choke. If I have to grab balls, I have to bite, I'll bite, but I'm gonna win. I'm never gonna lose.
Street fighting.
So what do you think of Nate Diaz?
Nate Diaz, I didn't know who the fuck he was, but he got down, he fucked, you know, he kicked what's in his ass and
Conor McGregor and
nothing
but
fucking, and then what he said after, you know,
I'm a bad motherfucker.
I'm a bad motherfucker. Whatever that shit, no, he's bad.
He's cool.
Bad
Robert,
so,
he's a bad motherfucker.
There's a guy from Music Corps.
They're calling me.
Oh, yeah. Well, so last thing, as we walk downstairs, what does it mean to Robert Garcia to be a champion? Because people work all their life to be a champion.
See, but right now people don't see me as the former world champion. People don't know I'm a former world champion. A lot of people only in boxing they know. Okay, Robert, former world champion. But right now they know me as a trainer, the one that, you know, made 9 world champions so far, beat Broner and probably one of my biggest wins with Maidana, fought Mayweather and almost beat him the first time with Maidana. That's what That's what a lot of fans see me. You know, they know me for being that the trainer now, not as the fighter. Let me try to get them. You need, they need to come with you now?
No, actually, I think you can leave them their clothes because they're wet. That way they can get changed.
Okay. Okay, and so you're going to come pick them up later?
Yeah, for now.
You're the mom? You're young. Wow. Okay, got it. Okay. I'll give them to him. All right, got it.
You know what Joe Guzan told me about you yesterday?
What did he say?
He said Robert Garcia is not only a Hall of Fame trainer, he's a Hall of Fame fighter, because you had the best left hook uppercut combo he's ever seen.
He said the same thing. And see, that's one thing, that's one punch that I try to teach my fighters, and very few do it. Boom, boom, you know, or boom. Yeah. But very few do that anymore. It's like Joe said, something nobody does anymore. Nobody does anymore.
And then the last thing. Yeah, one more song. All right, introduce yourself. ¿Cómo se llama?
Los de Cali. Somos los que estamos. Los de Cali somos todos nosotros, mire.
Los de Cali, the guys from Cali.
Which part?
Riverside.
Okay, so you should be the guys from Riverside.
Yeah.
What's the best song ever? The best, number one song in the world? Tres Animales?
You know that shit, don't
you? Yeah. No, what's the best? The best corrido?
Historia de Miguel Cuadras.
The history of Carlos Cuadras?
Historia de Miguel Cuadras.
Miguel history of Miguel Cuadras.
Why? Why is it the best?
¿Por qué? They made it.
Oh, okay, let's hear it. Last thing, I asked Mikey, when he comes back, who are the four people he could fight, if he could line them up? Terrence Crawford, Broner, Danny Garcia, and Pacquiao. How does Mikey do against those
guys?
Beats
everybody.
Why?
People might not think so, but you watch. When he comes back, he will fight those guys. He's going to beat them all.
All right, there you have it, Robert. Message to your fans if they're watching, Robert?
Enjoy our party. Family is nothing but family.